What is the class name? Nine. Got over? Why no? Inside a list iterator, there are some additional updatable methods like an add method, set method, not only remove method. In the list iterator, inside a list iterator interface, there is an add method. You cannot use a list.add in this location. Yesterday we have seen. We cannot use a list.add in this location. We are not using list.add. We are using add method of list iterator. It is a list iterator. It is a list iterator. We are adding element into the list iterator. Don't think like element is getting added into the list iterator. Yesterday I told very clearly, list iterator is not a container, but it is having an add method. Through that add method, we can add element into the array list only, not the list iterator. This is successfully adding. You are not getting a concurrent modification exception. You are not getting concurrent modification exception. We are able to add elements into the array list through list iterator add method after getting a list iterator and declaration. While adding element into the array list through list iterator, element is getting added left to the cursor of the list iterator. Remember this point. While adding element into the array list through list iterator, element is adding. In the array list, left to the pointer of the list iterator. Got it? Left to the pointer of the list iterator. As it is adding left to the pointer of the list iterator, while going in the forward direction, 50 is not iterating. While going to the reverse direction, 50 is iterating as a first member. Check it out. After getting a list iterator, we cannot add any element into the array list by using array list add method. After iterating only, we can use array list add method to add the elements into the array list. That we have seen practically yesterday. After getting a iterator or list iterator. You have to iterate the elements before adding elements into the array list. After iterating only, we can able to add elements into the array list. That is what we have seen yesterday. Now, after getting a list iterator, before iterating, we can add the element into the array list by using add method of the list iterator, not the add method of the array list. Yesterday we have seen array list add method, we were getting a concurrent modification exception. List dot add of 50, absolutely proper. Where this 50 is adding into the array list? left to the pointer, left to the cursor. List iterator is a pointer or a cursor to the array list. Left to that. By default, initially, list iterator referring to the first element. What is the first element in the array list? 90. 50 is adding left to the 90. But cursor will be at 90 only. While keep moving in the forward direction, it is reading from 90 onwards till to 40. While moving in the reverse direction, it is keep reading even 50 also. As 50 stored in the array list, left to 90. Cursor is at 90 only. While moving in the forward direction, it is reading 99040. Now cursor is at rightmost. You can go in the reverse direction. While reading in the reverse direction, you will be getting 40, then 0, then 9, then 90, then 50. List iterator containing add method. You can add element into the array list. Come to the next one.
Thank you.
inside a list iterator, there is another updatable method, that is set method. Whichever element is iterating, if that element is a 91, same is replacing to ABC. After iterating, you can print the list. While printing the list, 91 will not be. In place of 91, ABC will be. You can compile and run. So please observe, list iterator containing more methods compared to iterator. Both are the interfaces extends solid line. List iterator interface extending with iterator interface. List iterator interface extending with iterator interface. Iterator interface containing iterator interface containing these three methods. iterator interface containing these three methods. List iterator method, sorry, list iterator interface Add method, set method, additionally. What could be the next index? What was the previous index? That also you can identify while using list iterator. So a lot of interviewers are asking the differences between iterator and list iterator. Iterator is used only for iterating elements one time cut to in the forward direction. Through iterator, we can iterate all the elements only one time cut to in the forward direction. Only one time in the forward direction. Through iterator, we can read all the elements only one time in the forward direction. Through list iterator, We can read in the forward, backward, again forward, backward, again forward, backward, again forward. So any number of times we can iterate, there is a possibility of iterating in the backward direction. That is why we are able to read multiple times. Through list iterator, we can read the elements any number of times in any direction. The second difference, by using iterator, you can maximum remove, reading and remove only possible through iterator. Reading and remove, you cannot add, you cannot update. Through iterator, we can maximum read and remove, read and remove. You cannot add or you cannot update. You cannot add, you cannot update any elements through iterator. Whereas in the list iterator, not only read and remove, add and update also, add and set also. Not only reading elements from the array list, removing elements from the array list, you can able to add the element into the array list. You can able to update the element from the array list. Not only read and remove, you can go for done. Then, by using iterator, we cannot find out what could be the next index, what was the previous index. There is no way of reading index numbers in case of iterator. In case of list iterator, we can read next index, what could be, we can read previous index, what was. These are the differences between iterator and list iterator. Depending on your requirement, you get either iterator or list iterator. We got to know what is an iterator, what we can achieve through iterator, what is the list iterator, what we can achieve through list iterator. It's purely based on your requirement, what kind of facilities we are expecting. Based on that, you can get iterator or list iterator. Now, everybody might be getting a query like, why do we require this bloody iterator and list iterator? Why can't we achieve straight away through array list? Reading of every element from the array list, You can read through list itself. We have seen enhanced for loop, and we have seen the classical for loop, and even through two string method also, we can able to update, we can able to remove. We can do everything through array list reference. Why do we require a separate iterator, a separate list iterator? This is very important. Please observe. Whatever you are doing through iterator, same you can do through reference of the array list. Come on. Whatever you are doing through list iterator, same you can do through reference of the array list. Whatever we are doing through iterator, what we are doing through iterator, reading element one by one, whichever element we wanted, we can remove. That's all. Reading only one time, whichever element you wanted to remove while iterating, that element can be removed. Same can be achieved through array list. What we are achieving through list iterator, reading forward and backward while reading, not only remove, add and update. Same can be achieved through reference of array list. What is the need of list iterator? This is very important. Please observe. You want to share elements of array list to other customer. You want to share elements of array list to another program, to another module, to another service, to another customer, or to another thread. You want to share elements of array list to another web service, to another any kind of service, to another program, to another module, or to another customer, or to another project. If you are supplying a array list reference variable, then they can do anything inside that array list. They can do anything. You want to share your array list elements to another service. If you are supplying a array list reference variable to them, they can do anything. They will become a owner to your array list. They can read any number of times. They can even sort. They can remove all the elements. They can do any operation. You are the owner of your array list. You have a requirement of sharing elements of your array list to another customer, to another service, with a limited access. If you want to provide every access, then supply list itself to another customer. If you want to provide some limited access, then check it out whether iterator is suitable or list iterator is suitable. If it is an iterator, they can read only one time. While reading only, they can remove. After reading, they cannot remove. While iterating element one by one, whichever element they wanted, they can remove. They cannot go for second time. Once one element got iterated, that element cannot be removed. Yes, sir. Something like a limited access. If you want to provide some wider compared to iterator, more something like a features you are trying to provide, then go for list iterator. They can read any number of times. While reading, they can read, they can add, they can remove, add and update. They cannot go for sorting. They cannot go for removing a range itself. They cannot go for contains method. Lot more methods are there in the array list. All operations they cannot do if you are sharing your array list elements to other service through list iterator. Whatever methods are there in the list iterator, that only they can able to use. You will be finding lot of requirements where sharing elements of one container to another service. While sharing to another service, find out what kind of access you are giving to other service. If every kind of feature, then you can make other service itself a owner by supplying a array list reference variable itself. can do anything. If you want to provide a limited access, then check it out whether iterator or list. Got it out. So everywhere if elements are there, definitely those elements might be required to other service, might be required to other customer, might be required to other thread. If you want to share, then check it out how you want to share. If you want to share with all the access, no restriction, then go for unlist itself. If you want to provide some restrictions, then check it out. Iterator or this is very, very important. Before going to further, we need to know lambda expressions. While covering inner classes, we have seen static inner class, non-static inner class, and also local inner class and anonymous inner class. Advanced version of anonymous inner class is nothing but lambda expressions. Let us cover the lambda expressions. Through lambda expressions, we have to use comparator very extensively. Comparator, yesterday we have seen for sorting purpose. Nowadays, in every program, wherever comparator is coming, they using lambda expressions from JDK 1.8 onwards. Before JDK 1.8, in place of comparator usage, using anonymous inner classes. Compared to anonymous inner classes, lambda expressions are more convenient in place of single method interfaces. Comparator is a single method interface. How many methods are there in the comparator? 220. Define a separate development directory. Lambda expressions are introduced in JDK 1.8. JDK 1.8. First, let us see the requirement of the requirement of the lambda expressions. In the new development directory, thank you. we developed a separate class to implement method of the interface here. Separate class, that is P. Separate class for that is B. In which scenario we will be developing a separate class? If you wanted multiple objects, then create one object to be, one more object to be, one more object to be, one more object to be. Any number of objects to be. Interface A containing test method. Interface A type, we required multiple objects. Interface A type, we required multiple objects. We cannot create an object to A as it is an interface. We cannot create an object to A as it is an interface. We required multiple A type objects. A type objects. Now develop a B which is a subclass to A. B is having a name, class name B. Create one object to B, one more object to B, one more object to B. Any number of objects you can create to B. Program, I am showing only one object. You can create any number of objects. Perfectly name is there to the class B. Use the class B name, create any number of objects. If you wanted only one object of A type, is it required a separate B class? We can go for anonymous inner class. Copy the same program. It's not anonymous, another way of development. Copy the same program. Instead of separate B class, you can develop a B class as a static inner class. It is almost one and the same of previous approach, but here we are making B. It's a member of main class method, main method class. Here also you can create any number of objects to B. B became a member to M2. It's also almost one and the same, but here instead of outer class we are going for B as an inner class. You can create any number of objects to B. You can access B in outside M2 also. How you can access B in outside M2? Anybody? Come on.
Tama? How we can access B in outside AM2? By breaking one coconut. Hardly 2 weeks back only we have seen in their classes. M2.B for the reference variable. For the object, new space M2.B as it is a static. Start. Copy the same program. Local inner class. Now this class should be used only in the main method. It cannot be used in the outside as it is a local to main. But you can create any number of objects to B within the main method, any number of objects to B. Within the main method, we can create any number of objects to B. Any number of objects to be. But all the objects should be in the main method only, not in outside a main method. B is a local to main method. Any number of objects, local inner class. Any number of objects. Compile and run. If only one object is required, then anonymous inner class is a most suitable solution. If it is only one object, then the solution can be anonymous in that class. Is it the same output? Through anonymous inner class, we are designing a subclass to implementing concrete test method, implementing abstract test method, creating an object. In case of anonymous inner class, only one object. If you wanted one more object, you need to design one more anonymous inner class. Anonymous inner class, it doesn't have a name. You cannot refer same anonymous inner class to create a second object. Wherever anonymous inner class you are designing, there itself object should be created. At the place of the anonymous inner class, we can create an object. Whatever I selected, this is completely anonymous inner class, which is a subclass to A. For that anonymous inner class, we are using new operator. Please go through all inner classes, then you can understand. Just 2 weeks back only we have seen anonymous inner class, static inner class. I'm very sure like nobody reviving the covered content. I don't know how you are getting a sleep. Everybody sleeping 20 hours per day. Or I'm saying. If it is only one method, if it is only one method, A interface containing only one method, if it is only one method, what is the need of specifying a method? Why can't we implement straight away? If multiple methods are there, then implementation should be corresponding to a method. If two methods are there, some implementation in the first method, some other implementation in the second method. If only one method is there, what is the need of method name? Why can't you implement straight away? That is what lambda expression will be saying. Please observe. A interface containing only one method. Only one method. I don't require to specify method name. I'm telling like a method is starting. Nor the method is starting. It doesn't have any arguments. That implementation follows. Through arrow mark we are specifying like a implementation will be happening. If it is only one method, sorry, if it is only one statement, doesn't require the opening brace and closing brace. Only one statement. Now, inside a A interface, whatever test method is there, that is NOR the test method, that test method implementation. We are not specifying name of the method. We are specifying only like a NOR, as it is not having any arguments. Then we are telling like a implementation follows. This is what the implementation. In a single line, designing subclass to A, implementing test method, incorporating SOP in the test method, creating an object to that, returning that object to A1. Very simplified. So this right hand side meaning, the total meaning of the right hand side is designing a subclass to A. From A, whatever test method is inheriting, same is getting implemented. Designing a subclass to A, implementing test method in that subclass, making that subclass as a concrete. If that subclass is a concrete, is it possible to create an object? Object creation. Object is creating. That object is assigning to A1. Designing a subclass to A. Implementing every method of A. But here, multiple methods should not be. Lambda expression will not be supporting if multiple methods are there in the interface. Single method interface is only lambda expression. Single method interface. That is why method name is not required. If multiple methods are there, definitely you have to go for method names to specify which implementation coming under which method. There is only one method. If it is only one method, name not required, then only we can go for lambda expressions. Designing a subclass to A, implementing inherited abstract method of A, making that subclass as a concrete, creating an object. That object is returning to A1. You can call straight away A1.test. You can go for A1.test. A1 pointing to an object. That object is designed to subclass of A. In that subclass, test method got implemented with a single line implementation. You can call A1.test. Copy the same program. Thank you. So please observe, nor the method, implementation about to start with a opening brace and closing brace, multiple lines of implementation. In compile and run, if multiple statements of implementation, then only opening brace and closing brace required. Copy the same method is taking one argument, same we are specifying. Method is taking one argument, you can specify any identifier, same we are printing. Single line implementation, while calling a test method, 10 we are supplying to x, x is printing. Method is taking one out. Now inside interface here, test method taking one argument, while implementing, you have to supply that argument. Yes, we are supplying the argument. Earlier it was a no argument, now there is an integer argument. You can use in the implementation, single line implementation, we are using x. While calling test method, we are supplying a 10, 10 is assigning to x, x can be used in the implementation. Compile and run successfully. Copy the same. Small change, instead of int x, just x. No need of specifying data type to the argument. Multiple methods are not there, only one method. Data type is optional. As it is only one method, what is the need of specifying data type? Argument data type doesn't require. If multiple methods are there with the same name, then data types very much required to separate, to differentiate which method you are calling. Only one method, argument data type is optional. X is straight away, no need of int. Any identifier you can specify, straight away use that in the implementation. File and run. Come to the next one. This time test method taking two arguments. We are implementing test method through lambda expression. No need of data type to the arguments. Only one method. X will be qualifying as an int type. Y will be qualifying as a string type. Single method interfaces can be implemented through lambda expression. Single method interfaces Single method interfaces can be implemented through lambda expressions. You can compile and run. A interface containing a test method with the two arguments. Copy the same one. Method return type is int. If you are providing only return value, then return statement should not be here. If you are providing only return value, no other statements, then simply give value whatever you are returning. Now implementation is only with the return value. If it is only with the return value, return statement should not be kept. Lambda expressions are mainly for reducing number of statements. If it is only return value, what is the need of return statement?
lambda expressions are mainly introduced for reducing the statements.
If multiple statements are there, then the last statement should be a return statement. There you have to give a return. Here, only value you are returning, return should not be. Compile and run. You will be getting done with 200. Copy the same. If multiple statements are there, then return value should be with the return statement. Return value should be with the return statement if multiple statements are there. Come to the next one. straightforward. We are simply returning a value which is a sum of I and j. Single statement, only value return should not be here. Straightforward. Come to the next one. Same program, at the rate functional interface on top of the A. Program is same. At the rate functional interface. Lambda expressions are only for single method interfaces. All single method interfaces are called as a functional interfaces. Single method interfaces are called as a functional interfaces. If any interface containing only one method, that is called as a functional interface. Comparable, comparator, both are functional interfaces. Single method interfaces can be explicitly described as a functional interface by using one of the annotation. This is the built-in annotation through at the rate we have to use. What is annotation? How to define, how to use, that we'll come to know later. There is one built-in annotation which is used for functional interfaces. At the rate functional interface. Now if A containing multiple methods, you get compiled I method. We have to specify single method interfaces only as a functional interface. Single method interface only can be specified as a functional interface. This is compiling and running successfully. Copy the same. Two methods are there in the A interface. One is a sum, second one is a sub, subtraction. If any interface containing more than one method, then it should not be declared as a functional interface. It cannot be used in the lambda expressions. If any interface containing more than one method, then it should not be considered as a functional interface. It should not be described as a functional interface. It should not be described as a functional interface. Are you getting compile time error? Interface A containing more than one method and we marked that as a functional interface. Compiler checking whether A containing one method or more. If it is more than one, you will be getting compile time error. This is all about lambda expressions. My sincere advice, please go through completely inner classes one more time, then go through lambda expressions. Tomorrow I'll be using extensively anonymous inner classes and lambda expressions to use a comparator. 50% of collection API is comparator only. Other 50% is hash code method and equals method. So tomorrow's class is very important. You should understand clearly anonymous inner classes and the lambda expressions. Enjoy Karo. All the very best. We will see.